Unfortunately, most of the footage was lost. But I have pictures of the process. I begin the process by finishing up on the bucket head base. This took a little while because of the carving and the way the mannequin head was, but it was worth it all in the end. Towards the muzzle and the bottom jaw. It took a little while for me to figure out what works for me and how it should all go, but eventually I was happy with the progress. As you can see here, I started to try and get ready on the little cheek pieces for the muzzle to make it look more plushed out. I struggled with it a few times because I wasn't sure the right size or the right shape. I wasn't taking measurements. I usually go off an estimated guess, and eventually I found something that worked. For all the random cutting out. The camera wasn't working properly that day. I don't know what was wrong with it. I would have to do something else to record most of the time. But for the most part, I was getting, as you can see, I got the top jaw done, and I'm currently working on the bottom jaw. It was a little hard to carve out since I felt like it didn't fit as much, but the client was happy, so I was happy with the result. I started cutting out just a little bit of foam to push out the nose, as I didn't want it to sit too flat. I also etched a ridge piece to the muzzle to smoothen out the transition when making the brow piece. This part here, I was just making the cheek pieces, and I was trying something new with it to see if it would turn out, and I say, especially with the carving, it turned out fairly well. Thank you. bottom jaw, and I immediately started gluing on. I had to be careful with the placement here because I didn't want it to seem off, and I wanted it to seem symmetrical and in line with the eye. But overall, the result was pretty good. So that way I could finish up and making the little eyebrow pieces, where I like to call the beads, and I would start on the ears, and that would probably be one of the most struggles that I've had throughout this whole fursuit head. But nonetheless, I took an estimated guess on where it would be, using the eyes as a sort of a guide. It was a little too thick, so I had to cut it down and trim it down, but in the end it came out very well. I drew down the general shape that I wanted and went off of there. I was mostly going off of the ref sheet instead of more references wise, being how I wasn't exactly sure of the dog breed, so I went off what I could go.
Thank you. it is done, for the most part. Now, it's not exactly done just yet, but this is the most I can do for it, being how I, where I currently am, I do not live here. And I will be returning home, and this is going with me. So part two will be out as soon as I can get this ship down and be able to be worked with. Also, please ignore the sound in the background. But this is the client's fursuit, the first customer so far, and I like the way this turned out. You know, despite mannequin head putting it at a 90 degree angle, but nonetheless, it is done, it's dealt with. I honestly like it. The client is happy with how it came out, and that is all that matters to me. So, I will get started on part two. I still need to finish the eyes. I have the fur. Next time I'm going to make a pair of paws. And that will be general fun, since the fur is about 1 yard, and for 1 yard, it's pretty large, and I can make some small pair of paws. So, we will get back to when this is getting fully finished.